You still wake up. It's almost 12, my dear. Yes, Mom. I'm doing homework from Boo Rumunda. It must be submitted tomorrow. Don't be late to bed. Okay, Mom. Just a few minutes again. Are you going to campus now, my dear? Yes, Mom. I'm waiting for Anning. I think she is just coming. I hope so.
You look sleepy, Oda.
Yeah. I went to bed late. I did Boo Rumunda's assignment.
I see. I've just done it yesterday. By the way, have you read The Soldier by Rupert Brooke? We have another assignment from Pa Pepin, right? We have to write an essay about identity and war.
Yes, I have. It is about a soldier who glorifies his motherland, England. It is a sonnet, right?
Yeah, it is a sonnet. This sonnet talks about the speaker's death and what to think about him after he dies.
He calls himself dust, so he wants to be buried on the land of England. And he will die peacefully and go to English heaven.
Yeah, I've just written a little about that. We need to look for other references in the library. Can we go now?
What about the death of the ball turret gunner? Have you read it?
Yeah, I have. This is a short poem presenting a message about there is no glory in war, isn't it?
I think so. From the title we can see that the poem is about the death of a man, a mere soldier, whose death is so common to the state.
The phrase mother's sleep is a metaphor. The speaker falls from the mother's womb to the state's womb. And he is very weak to control the situation.
Another womb metaphor in this poem is I hunched in its belly. The gunner, who is in the plains ball turret gunner, is like the position of the fetus in the womb.
But it is contrast, where the mother's womb feels warm, while the state's womb feels cold and gripping. So he calls it my wet fur froze.
I think this poem is a critic to the power of politics and the state, where a person is only considered as a soldier.
Yeah, I do agree about that. The mother gives life, however, the state, through the ball turret gunner, gives death.
War remains only bitterness and misery. There is no glory in war.
Yeah, there is no glory in war.
Here we are. Come on. Let's get off.
Okay.
What other poems we have to read and analyze?
The Charge of the Light Brigade by Alfred Tennyson and Philip Larkin's 1914.
We can discuss them at the library.
Okay. Have you found the book?
I'm afraid not. Have you?
Me neither. Perhaps someone borrows it. Let's sit and discuss other poems.
The Charge of the Light Brigade tells of acts of courage and sacrifice during the Crimean War.
Yes. This poem explains that the cavalry's willingness to sacrifice themselves made them worthy of being called heroes.
The poem shows that heroism is not only about courage, but also about duty, to be willing to obey orders at all costs.
They were surrounded by enemy weapons, with cannon to the right of them, cannon to the left of them, cannon in front of them. Wherever they moved, they were stormed at with shot and shell. And they only had bare sabers.
In other words, they only had swords, while their enemies had full firearms. This was a suicide mission.
Yes. A suicide mission. The cavalry must continue fighting, despite the fault of the chain of command over them. They still carry out these orders.
I think the poem tries to criticize the military leaders responsible for the fault of the chain of command.
Yeah. This poem praises the soldiers themselves more, celebrating their sacrifice, their courage, and their commitment to their country.
Anning, let's go to the conference room. I want to show you something.
Okay.
When we read 1914, it's like we see a picture in 1914. Here, we can see men who have just signed up to go fight in the war. Those long uneven lines, standing as patiently as if they were stretched outside,
The Oval or Villa Park?
I see. From the poem, it is clear that they have no idea what is going to happen to them. The year 1914 was the year of the outbreak of the First World War, in August 1914.
In the second stanza, the speaker pictures the situation of the shop fronts in those days. And in the third stanza, the poem zooms out, describing the countryside and then all of England.
This is the message that there are going to be so many changes in the coming years.
Yeah, everything is going to be different and innocence is going to be lost.